Hey guys, happy Monday morning. My name is Nicole. I'm one of the teaching pastors here at The Crossing Church. I found a cool little corner for me to do our Monday Bible study from. So every Monday morning, we are doing a Bible study where we are looking at what we talked about this last weekend and then getting in just a little bit deeper, thinking about it from a different angle. And so this last weekend was Father's Day weekend and our speaker was Patrick Deccan. And if you missed it, you need to go back and watch this service. There is a fire to it, and it's about legacy. It's about how our lives can matter beyond just ourselves. And all throughout this series called OMG, Oh My God, we're calling it that because we are in a time in life where we need to know we can call out to God. We can call on God at any time, and He is there and He is present. And that is what gives us the power and strength to have a legacy. And so this last weekend, when Patrick was talking about Moses, he mentioned that even Moses felt insecure at times. Even Moses questioned whether he really could be the one that was used to bring freedom to the world. And that really struck me. So in Moses's life, he's going about his regular business. He is a shepherd. He's out. He's got his staff in his hand and he's taking care of his normal day. And that's when he sees the burning bush and he walks over to it and he looks at it. And he notices that it's on fire, but it's not burning up. And that's how God gets his attention, as that's when God starts speaking to Moses. And so they start talking and God basically says to Moses, hey, there is suffering in the world. There are people who are suffering and people who need help. And I'm going to help them, and I'm going to help them through you. And Moses says, I am not so sure about that. Can you please give me some more information about you, about how I'm supposed to talk to these people, what I'm supposed to do? And God basically just says, I will go with you. Now go. And Moses says, are you sure? Do I need more tools? I need more something. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. How am I supposed to do this? And this is in Exodus 4 in verse 2, right as Moses is asking again, are you sure? Are you sure I'm the one who's supposed to help bring freedom? Are you sure I'm the one who's somehow supposed to be a leader that's supposed to step into this hard situation and make things better? Right at that moment where Moses is asking that again, God just says to Moses, what is in your hand? And Moses looks down and it's his staff. It's his shepherd's staff. That's what's already in his hand. It's been in his hand all along. This is his daily job. That is a tool that is always with him. It's something he uses every day. It's a mundane, ordinary part of his life. God says, that thing that is already in your hand, that is what I'm going to use to change the world. That staff that Moses was carrying, his everyday staff, is the same staff that then was the one that helped part the Red Sea, that the people of God walked through the ocean with walls of water on either side of them. And God used Moses and his regular mundane staff to create that moment. And it really had me thinking. So in this time that we are in, maybe you are hearing God speak to you as you pray. You're hearing God say things like, I want you to be someone who brings more freedom into the world. I want you to be someone who steps in to that problem that you see, to not just complain about it, but to make it better. I want you to be the one who leads. I want you to be the one who speaks up. I want you to be the one who steps in and fights for good, for love, for freedom. And you may be like Moses, where you're thinking, no way, I have no background in that. I don't know what I'm supposed to say. Why would they listen to me? I need more tools. I need more education. I need more of something before I'm able to step into that, God. And what I want you to hear God say to you right now is, what is already in your hand? Because God is going to use the ordinary things in your life to do extraordinary things if you invite Him into it. And so what is already in your life What are your skills? What are your talents? What are your passions? What are your resources? Today, invite God in to use everything you already have to bring freedom into the world. He is calling you to be the one to step in with what you already have. What is already in your hand that you can use to bring freedom? I want to pray for us as we close out. This was from Exodus 3 and then Exodus 4, if you want to go and look at that story where Moses and God are speaking. But God's calling us to something with what we already have today. We don't need to wait till tomorrow. We don't need to wait till there's more tools. We don't need to wait till we feel more qualified. God qualifies you. You are qualified. If there is something you care about, if you feel called to something, then you step into it now. You don't need to wait. You can step into it now. So let me pray for us. God, thank you for the story of Moses. Thank you for Exodus 3 and 4, for the story of a man who you called to fight for freedom, to be a leader, to use what he had and offer it to you and what you're already doing in the world. God, help us to know where we can step in and be a part of what you are already doing in the world. Help us to listen carefully. God, we know that you are already working for freedom, for good, for love. Help us to know how to join you in that. And God, I pray right now that you'll give us the space to take stock, to see what is already in our hands. What skills you've given us, what resources you've given us, what talents and passions you've given us. And that you've called us to use them today to bring goodness and glory to the world. Thank you, God, for calling us. Amen. Well, thank you guys so much for joining me. Thank you for praying with me. Thank you for talking about Moses and Exodus with me. There's so much for us to get from these stories. So much that can free us to really living each day with purpose. If you have not watched this weekend service, go back and watch it right now. It's on Facebook. It's on our website, thecrossing.com. It's on YouTube. It's all over the place. Watch it. Let it inspire you. We are in this together as always, and we will see you every day online. Thanks, everybody.